Good morning, Kevin. I hope that you are well and fine. Now I am going to discuss another lesson, lesson number 18, that is independent of India. The first 30 years of journey, right from 1947 to 1977. So India was freed from Britishers in the year 1947-1950, that we all know. After freedom, India has faced many challenges. The challenges are very new to India, very very new. Democratic government, constitution, conducting of general elections, social and economic changes, foreign policies, like that, many challenging tasks were there before the Indian government. This challenging task was not that much easy to come ahead, to go ahead. The early years after independence are arguable. The defining period in India's post-independent history, where main challenges was the need to maintain, the first main challenge was to need to maintain unity and integrity, bring about a social and economic transformation for successful working of the democratic government. For successful working of the democratic government, the first thing, the most challenge for the Indian government is to maintain unity and integrity in the state, in the country, and to maintain social and economic changes in the country. Apart from that, still many other are there where the government has to face all these challenges. So, what are the challenges faced by India after independence? So, India, independent India, the first 30 years of 1947 to 1977, the journey of 30 years after independence. During the 30 years, what are the changes that have been taken place in India? So let us see now. First one is independent India. So in the independent India, first general elections, then 140 dominance was there, then demand for state reorganization, then social and economic changes, then foreign policy and wars, green revolution, rise of regional parties and regional movements, and emergency. These are all the main tasks where the Indian government faced. Apart from that, the constitution also came into force after independence. So we know that on 26 January 1950, our Indian constitution came into force. Dr. Babu Rajendra Prasad is the first president of independent India. Right. Then, here, first Prime Minister of India is independent India is our beloved Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru. The second Prime Minister of India is Lal Bahadur Shastri. The next is the only one lady Prime Minister of India, that is Srimati Indira Gandhi. Only lady Prime Minister so far, only one was there. After her, nobody ruled over Gandhi. That is, lady Prime Minister was not the only Indira Gandhi. So Indira Gandhi, during Indira Gandhi rule, she took left turn and she had given one slogan, that is Garibi Hatao. During Indira Gandhi rule only, emergency has been declared.
Right, children. See here, you can see
during Indira Gandhi rule, what are the changes she has taken place during her rule. First, she gave a slogan, Garibi Hatao. After that, she started abolishing princely pensions. Means, after independence, the different colonies or different areas or the states, different states were used to rule by the kings, queens and nawabs. During India's reorganization, reformation, under the leadership of Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, he has collected all the princely states and joined in India and made India as one country. So for at that time, he promised that he is going to give pensions to the princes. So during Indira Gandhi rule, she abolished princely pensions. Then she nationalized banks. Then she announced emergency during her period of late. So why she announced emergency, that we know in the coming class. Then left her turn. So what are the things that we come across during Indira Gandhi rule and independent India? So this is the 30 years journey. And especially Indira Gandhi rule, what happened in that during that rule, that is there. Now here, yes. That is 1947 to 1977. What are the changes that have been taken in India? Among them, the first one is first general election. First general election.
So, what are the challenges faced by India after independence?
The first 30 years of Germany. That right, that is from 1947 to 1977. What is the first step being taken by Indian government? The first general elections. The first general election. At that time, the first election commissioner of India. First election commissioner of India. Who can you guess? He is Mr. Sukumar. Sukumar Sen is the first election commissioner of India. During his rule only, first general elections have been conducted. At that time in India, most of the people are illiterate, means they are not educated. And during that period, it has become a very big task, a very big problem for the election commission and for the Indian government also to conduct the elections. How to conduct the elections? At that time, the election commissioner has came out with one idea, one solution, that giving symbols to all party nations, different daily regular symbols to all party nations, like car, bicycle, flower, and like the different symbols has been given to different parties for the identification of the parties and to cans and pots. That was the technique which was used in the year 1951. The first general election was held in the year 1951. And during Sukumar Sen is the first chief election commissioner of India. As election commission was set up, take care of the practical matters, conducting elections across the length and breadth of the country. So across the length and breadth of the country, elections have been conducted. In independent India, first general election in the year 1952. So first general election has been conducted in the year 1952, then 1957. 1952, 1957, then 1962. These are the years where the first general elections were held. And Indian National Congress consistently win over 70% of the seats and form the government. And Indian National Congress, that is INC, consistently ruled the party by gaining 70% of the seats. So by gaining 70% of the Lok Sabha seats, they ruled the country continuously for 3 decades. And won the government in many states as well. Jawaharlal Nehru was the first Prime Minister of India. It was the strength of the constitution, framework, and the democratic foundations led by the freedom movement enabled Indian politics to develop a multi-party democracy. Yes. It was the strength of the constitutional framework and democratic foundation led by the freedom movement which enabled Indian politics to develop a multi-party democracy. Next, so the first one is first general elections. So 1947 to 1977, what are the challenges India faced? Among the first challenge is how to conduct the elections in India. That was the first challenge faced by India. Right? First general elections were held in the year 1952, then 1957, then 1962. Continuously, the largest party in India is Indian National Congress, won and started ruling the party, ruling the country. And even in the states also, only Indian National Congress party was there. And then the first election commission of India is who?
Mr. Sukumar Sen.
What was the next challenge faced by India? One party dominating the political system. One party dominance. One party dominance in the political system. Here, after independent India, the largest party or the biggest party in India is only one party. That is the Indian National Congress. During that period, the dominance during that period in independent India, the first three general elections were held in the year 1952. So first general elections were held in the year 1952, then 1957, then 1962. During these 3 periods, continuously, the Indian National Congress won, reducing the other participants to almost nothing. Jawaharlal Nehru became the Prime Minister of India. None of the other parties individually got more than 11% of the votes. So during this period, the other parties, many other parties were also there. Democratic Party, Social Party was there, Communist Party was there, Janata Dal Party was there, like that different parties were there. All parties together, they got only 11% of the votes during these 3 periods. Only 11% of the votes won. The Congress consistently won over 70% of the seats by obtaining 45% of the total votes. No other party was anywhere near the Congress. So any party was very near to Congress. Means all are very far away from the Congress majority. Means Congress party has got a huge majority. Political competition in the one party dominant system therefore took place within the Congress The opposition party is therefore only for a laggard and not a real threat. Yes, only one party dominant was there, right from 1958 to 1947 to 1977. This will help me, right? Yes. The opposition party therefore only for the legend and not a threat. The next one is demand for state reorganization. The next challenge here by the Indian government is the demand for the state reorganization.
Listen to this very carefully for two times or three times. After that, prepare a note or you are having the material with you. You read the questions that are present in your material and write without seeing your examination book. Right, children. Thank you. Take care. Bye.